Merry meet everyone. This is Shiv Shakti from Goddess Breath, and I am here to give you your weekly reading. I hope you guys had a great weekend. Mine was extremely revelationary. That's all I can say about it. Okay, so let's start with Monday and Tuesday. It is a Three of Swords, but there is nothing to be worried about, because the Three of Swords not only means heartbreak and criticism, it also means constructive criticism. It also means that you get a chance to see how the other person looks at you, or even how you look at yourself in a not so great light. It is your chance to kind of, you know, be able to see how you react to how people think about you, or how you really think about you. Because, you know, we are the first people to go, oh my god, I'm so silly, I don't know what's going to happen. We're so much like that. But Monday and Tuesday is a chance for us to get up, realize that, and change the way we talk to ourselves. Talking to ourselves is extremely important, and talking to ourselves well is even more important. It's as simple as this. If you don't value you, nobody else is going to value you. So this Monday and Tuesday is a chance to understand how much you value yourself, and how open and how positively you can actually take what another person has to say to you without it being oh so lovely and oh so glossy, right? So it's an opportunity to grow, right? And Wednesday, ta-da! The Two of Cups, it is such a beautiful card. It's actually the card I got the very first time I ever picked up a card in a tarot deck. Okay, so this is a card of a lot of healing, a lot of togetherness, and a lot of seriousness on a topic that you are maybe flirting with a little bit. You know, like Monday and Tuesday could be a little bit of illness as well, like a little palpitation, a little blood pressure, something to do with blood. But this, again, being water, you know, the water element, it also could be about blood. And this being Navratri, we usually know that, you know, the goddess likes blood. So if she wants you to give her blood, she will find a way just to create a small paper cut on your hand. Or, you know, it could be something bigger. But I don't see a need to get scared, because these are very happy cards. So Wednesday is a day where you kind of finally admit to something that is going from being just a flirtatious relationship to something a little more serious. It is going to be extremely healing for you. It's going to be very powerful for you, because this unity that you're going to form, either with yourself, you know, to understand that, okay, I'm going to work with myself, I'm going to be cordial to myself, I'm not going to ill-treat myself. So it's you and you, you know, it's a beautiful union. Or it is with someone else. And if there's a chance to have a union with someone else, please do not hesitate. Go ahead and make that union happen. Extremely important for you. Have a lot of water. Be out in nature. I don't know why spinach seems to be coming to me, so try and involve spinach in your food. Thursday and Friday. What became serious on Wednesday, through the Four of Wands, is becoming a long-term commitment. Again, it could be to yourself, or it could be to, you know, something that you plan to do. And it's a very, very strong message here, because you have to learn to celebrate this commitment. It has got to be a most opening and... I'm falling short of words. It's just like opening your heart up wide, you know. And be it work or personal life, there is something that's going to change into a little bit of a seriousness thing. And it is going to last long, because it is really, really beautiful. It is a very, 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 and I cannot stop insisting on the amount of varies, I can say, positive growth. So Thursday and Friday has you dancing, and has you celebrating, and has you making a commitment, and a very positive one at that, like I said. So that's a beautiful week. Just be careful of Monday and Tuesday, right? But oh, they'll pass away in jiffy. Okay, so because it's Navratri, instead of just picking out unicorn cards, I've picked out two cards from the Tantric Dakini Oracle for us. I was actually planning to pick up one as usual, but two have popped out. So the first one that came out is this one. Isn't it just beautiful? It says Mount Meru, the center of the universe. And in keeping with what's happening in the week, I would say that the goddess is giving you a hint. You are the center of your own universe. No matter what it is, remember, it all comes from you and all comes back into you. But I'd also say, be aware of the spine. Do flexibility exercises. It is extremely important for you to pay attention to your health and not just get dreamy about it, you know, live up in the clouds. But you must kind of understand that you are your own mountain. You are your own solid space. And no matter what it is, you can always fall back on you. Oh my God, I'm just realizing this week is all about you starting or carrying forward your experience of having confidence on you. It's like looking into the mirror early in the morning and going, I know you're there for me and I'm there for you too. I mean, that is exactly what it is all about. And when you do that, you know, you reach a different height in your consciousness level, and that is where the second card comes in. It's Soma, the mushrooms, it's intoxication. And this is not a wrong kind of intoxication. This is the intoxication of confidence. It is the intoxication of understanding the self, of realizing your own power, of understanding that there is so much within you, that you are so powerful and that you're so magical that you don't need anything external to make you that high. Wow. Can you imagine being your own drug? This card is giving you a chance to be your own drug. Wow. I love this reading. Can you see how beautifully the goddess is pushing us towards ourselves, the within ourselves? Because like she always says, I live within you. My God, and she's giving us this absolutely beautiful message. So I hope this makes sense to you, and I hope you can, you know, involve this message and this guidance in your week and really see the powerful you that you really are. And just let it be if someone doesn't want to see it. It really doesn't matter, because you are the most important part of this week for you. So it's better if everybody else is the most important part for themselves in their week, right? But please remember that there is nothing and no one more powerful than you are in your own life. I hope you have a great weekend. Great week. I'm so looking forward to weekend now. I hope you guys have a great week, and meditate a little bit if you can, because you know the goddess kind of speaks to us in moments of silence. And your meditation could be anything. It doesn't have to be like, you know, sitting with your eyes closed and having your hands in chin mudra only. It could be a walk in nature. It could be a long bath. It could be anything. It could be absolutely anything. It could be just blanking out your mind while you play a video game on autopilot. You know, it could be even that. It doesn't matter. The idea is to come into your silent space and stay there for a while, and to open your other perception out to the universe and allow it to talk to you. I hope you have a great, great week. Love you so much. Mwah.